योगः कर्मसु कौशलम्।
नमस्कार, वेलकम टू यूजीसी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर ऑफ गुजरात यूनिवर्सिटी अहमदाबाद। आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर जगदीश जोशी, प्रोफेसर एंड डायरेक्टर ऑफ दिस यूजीसी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर ऑफ गुजरात यूनिवर्सिटी अहमदाबाद। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस ई कंटेंट सीरीज, डिस्कशन सीरीज ऑफ यूजीसी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर ऑफ गुजरात यूनिवर्सिटी अहमदाबाद। फ्रेंड्स, दिस HRDCs आर मेंट फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस, ऑल द ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेस or the academicians and administrators working in the field of higher education. Our basic goal, our motto is to equip, to develop and update the professionals, the academicians and administrators working in higher education in India. We impart professional development training to all college and university teachers, as well as university and college administrative and non-teaching professionals. We are going to talk about use of ICT in higher education today. I'm very happy to introduce the resource person of today, Dr. P.V. Virpara. Dr. Virpara has been working in the field of higher education since last 30 years, maybe more than 30 years. He is a name which is known to all the people who are working in computer science in Gujarat. He is a professor of computer science in Sardar Patel University, Vallabh Vidyanagar. The university is one of very reputed universities in India. Friends, Dr. Virpara is a synonym of researches in computer science. He has carried out various research projects. He has guided various PhD scholars. He has guided various MPhil scholars. And he has successfully guided various research projects on computer science. He has various reputed research papers at his credit. He deliberated various sessions at UGC Human Resource Development Centers of India, and he has widely published. I am very happy to invite Dr. P.V. Virpara for his scholarly session.
Hello. Today, we are going to discuss about Microsoft Excel. Basically, this is a software known as a spreadsheet program or spreadsheet software. It is a part of Microsoft Office. You might have heard about Microsoft Word. It is a word processor or used to create the word processing, used to create documents. Then Microsoft PowerPoint. It's a presentation tools used to prepare the presentation. Then Microsoft Access is a database software used to create the database, manipulate the database. Similarly, this Microsoft Excel is a spreadsheet program, basically used for calculation purpose. It is used to create the charts very easily. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about that Microsoft Excel. So to start that Microsoft Excel, first you have to click on this start button, and then you have to find out this Microsoft Excel. So when you click on this Microsoft Excel, you will get a screen like this one. Now here, if it is not, you can say visible or the size is small, you can increase the zoom level. Okay. Now here in this case, in this screen, we'll get here the ribbon in which we are getting different menu items like home, insert, page layout, formula, data, review, view, Acrobat. Then here we'll get the options related to the item that you are selecting. This is a formula bar, and this is known as a worksheet area in which we can work or we can enter the data. Now here, this entire worksheet, as you can see, is a collection of rows and columns. Here, this intersection of row and column is known as a cell. It is known as a cell. In this particular cell, we can enter any data of our choice. The data may be either a numeric data like this one, or it may be you can say a data with decimal points, or it may be you can say a negative data also. All right. Same way we can enter a text, or you can say string type of values, right? Any kind of value we can enter consists of different characters. Then apart from this numerical data and the string type of data, we can also enter a formula. Now in a formula, in this Excel, the formula starts with a equal sign. So first we have to write the equal sign, and then afterward we can write any formula. So it will calculate the formula and the result will be displayed in the cell. And apart from this, Excel provides a very huge amount of you can say built-in functions that also we can use in a cell. So when we click on this insert button, insert function button, immediately here we'll get the list of the functions in a different categories. We'll see about this later on, but that we can use in a cell. So in a cell we can enter any kind of data. Now, one more thing is that whenever we want to do anything in this one, then first we require to input the basic data. We have to enter basic data, and then we can perform any kind of calculations on that data, or we can prepare the chart, pivot tables, and number of things are available here that we can perform on the basic data. But here the basic things that we have to, you can say, required is to enter the basic data. Now here, this, you can say entire screen is divided into number of rows and number of columns. The column is, you can say, given a name as, you can say, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And this particular thing, as we have 26 alphabets, so after 26 alphabets there is a repetition of two characters. Okay, then there is a repetition of three characters, and finally the last column is having the heading as XFD. Okay, XFD. And the row numbers are given as a serial sequence number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that will continue up to 1048576, that is 10,48,576 rows are there in a one sheet. So we can have a matrix consisting of this many columns and this many row in which we can enter the data. Going for any further topic, I'll tell you, whenever you want to enter any data in a cell, first of all, you have to move your cursor in that particular cell. Okay, so for moving the, you can say cursor in a cell, you can use this arrow keys, or otherwise, if that particular cell is, you can say at a different place, then you can use a function key F5. Before that, let I tell you one thing. Each and every cell in a worksheet is identified by an unique cell, a unique address, a unique address, okay? So here, this particular cell, for example, is having the address D3 because it is in a column D and row 3, right? Similarly, this cell is having the address G5 because it is in column G and row 5, right? And here in this particular formula bar, you can also see that particular address of the current cell pointer. Okay, so we can refer the content of any cell by using its address. So if I want to move to a particular location, okay, then I can use these arrow keys, or otherwise I can press the F5 key, function key F5. So when I press the F5 key, it will ask to enter the cell address where I want to jump. Suppose I want to jump at cell address Z100. Press it. So directly it will move you to the cell having the address Z100. Right? So this F5 function key is used to move your cell pointer to a particular location. Okay, now as I have mentioned that first of all we require to enter the basic data. So let me allow some basic data. Basic pay. Now here just we want to have this particular four fields, or you can say four information about the employees. We have a employee number, employee name, designation, and basic pay. So here I have just entered the field name in the first row, and then in the subsequent rows we have to enter the data, or you can say records. Now here as an employee number, we have to enter the numbers. Here, while entering the number, you can enter either in the row wise or in the column wise, doesn't make any difference. So let's enter some employee name. Okay, so in this way we have entered the data. Then designation, so let's enter some valid designation name, so that later on when we are doing some processing on that one, we'll have some valid name. And accordingly, let us enter some basic pay. For clerk, the basic pay is 15,000. Professors, for example, 75,000. Then assistant professor, say 45,000. Then say professor, 90,000. Clerk, say for example, 23,000. Assistant professor, let's have 38,000, and a professor, for example, 95,000, or let's say 85,000. Okay, after entering this basic data, we can format this data, right? We can format this data. So if you are aware about the formatting features and what Microsoft Word, the similar thing, or in the same way, we can also format this Excel data. For example, if I want to change the font for all this data, I have to just select using your mouse key, you can select this particular you can say data, and here is the selection of the font. You can select the appropriate font. You can change the size of this particular, you can say, content. There is an option bold, italic, underline. Okay, then you have a color and all that things. Okay, now suppose this particular data, that is the employee number. Now you can observe here that the numeric data, whatever we are entering in the cell, all are right justified by default. All are right justified by default. Whereas this textual data, string type of data, are by default left aligned. Okay. So here, this data, suppose we require to display in a, this we want to display in a center of the cell. So select this one, and here are the three buttons for the alignment. Align the text left, center, and right. Okay. So if we select this option, then this data is displayed in the center of the cell or in the column. Right, then suppose we require to draw a box among the cells, then select this one, and here is an option to display the border. So let's select this all border. So we'll have this type of, you can say, border across the cells. Then in the first row, to distinguish it from the data, suppose we want to display it in a bold face, so select that row and then click on this button. Then to display it in a different color, background color. Okay. So in this way, you can format your data. Depending upon your choice, you can select the appropriate disconnecting. Okay. So after entering this basic data, as I have mentioned, we can perform the calculations on the basic data, or we can have different options like preparing the chart, creating the pivot tables, what if analysis can be performed. Number of things are there in this Excel. Here, let us perform some calculation on the basic data. Now let us calculate first a simple one, that is a dearness allowance, DA. Now suppose the DA is, let us assume, 25% of the basic pay. So here we can write a formula to calculate the DA as 25% of basic pay. So as I have mentioned, that the formula starts with equal sign. So let's write the equal sign. Now, the basic pay data is available in the column D, and particularly for this record, it is available in D2, cell D2. Okay, so here we just have to write the cell address in which the basic data for this particular employee is stored. And then afterward, multiplication sign, and then as it is at 25%, the simple formula is, we can write 25 divided by 100 to get the 25% of the content of T2, plus enter key. So here we'll have option, or we'll get the value 3750, that is, you can say, the 25% of the basic pay, or you can say 25%. Okay, after entering this particular formula, when we press enter key, we will get the result directly in a particular cell. Okay, that is 3750. But the formula, whatever we have written, is not visible here in this case by default. If you want to see that one, you can take your cursor on that one, and then afterward in this formula bar, it display the formula whatever we have entered. Okay, or otherwise when you double click on this one, it will show you that particular formula whatever we have entered in a cell. Okay, now next thing is the formula whatever we have entered is required to copy to all other records or all other rows. So there are different methods available using which we can copy the formula entered in a particular cell to the other cells. So one of the simplest way is you double click on this particular corner, that is at the right bottom corner, where you will see a filled square. Okay, so when you double click on this one, immediately the formula whatever we have written in E2 is copied to rest of the records, or you can say rest of the rows. Now here, look at this. We have entered a formula D2 multiplied by 25 upon 100 in E2. Now when it is copied to E3, then the row number is automatically changed. Look at this formula. In this formula, okay, you will see D3 multiplied by 25 upon 100. So same way, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8. So this type of addressing is normally known as relative addressing. In Excel, this type of addressing is known as relative addressing. Relatively, it will change the row number, right? So that is one of the way to copy the formula entered in a particular cell. The another way is you can drag this corner to the required rows. Okay, you can drag this one to the required row. And the third one is select a cell in which we have entered a formula, and then afterward there is an option copy over here. So select this option copy, and then afterward select the cells in which we require to paste this particular formula. So after selecting that one, paste. So in that way also we are getting the result. So these are the way to copy the formula from one cell to another cells, or cell or cells. Okay. Now, there is one option available over here known as a format painter. Basically, this format painter is used to copy the formatting features that we have applied in some of the cells to other cells. Okay, for example, here in this row, we have applied some features like the first row contains, value displayed in a red color, background color is yellow, and the font is, Arial, and size is 12. So this thing we require to copy to column E also. So here for that, you just select this row, click on this format painter, and then afterward select the row or a column in which you want to apply that particular formatting feature. So that's a very good feature available here, format painter. Otherwise, what we have to do? Again, we have to select the font. We have to select the font size. Then you can say for first row, we have to select the appropriate color and the background color, everything. But using this format painter, we can do it very easily. Same way, let's have a column of PF. Suppose that PF is 10% of basic pay. Okay, so again, to calculate it as a 10% of basic pay, let us start with a equal sign. Then, okay, it is 10% of basic pay. So we have to write appropriate formula for calculating the PF as 10% of basic pay. So here we have to write the address of the cell in which the basic pay is stored. It is in D2 for this particular record. So no need to type the cell address. We can directly get the cell address by clicking on a particular cell. See, when I have clicked on that particular cell, the cell address is appeared in this formula, D2. And then afterward, 10% of basic pay. So here, either you can write 10 divided by 100, or if you write directly 10%, then also it is okay. Okay. So here in this way, we can write it, and then we can copy this one to rest of the records. And then we can, let's copy this format to this one also. So in this way, we can perform the calculation on any of the basic data that we have entered. In this way, we can have any number of columns, as we are having different columns in our salary slips. So depending upon that criteria, we can create the columns, right? Right now, let us assume that we have only these three columns, and then finally, let us calculate the gross pay and then total deduction and then net pay. Okay, gross pay means the total of all the earnings. Now at this moment, we have only two earnings, that is a basic pay and the DA. These are the only two earnings in this case. Okay, so let's find the sum of these two cells or these two entries. Okay, so we'll get here 18,750. And the deduction, we have only one column as a deduction, that is a professional tech PF, provident fund. Okay, so here, just to copy this value, we can select that one and paste it over there, or otherwise we can write equal to F2, so it will directly copy this particular value from the column of PF to deduction. And then afterward, we can have here calculation of net pay. That is nothing but gross pay minus deduction. So gross pay is available in G2. And then afterward, we have deduction in H2. So let's write G2 minus H2. That will give you here. And to apply these formatting features, select any cell and then apply to so in this way we can calculate anything based on the basic data available. Now, there is a very good facility in this Excel, and that is a automatic recalculation. Now, say for example, after some period of time, if there is a change in the basic salary of any particular employee, for example, the employee Akshar is having a basic pay as 85,000. Now, after some period of time, it becomes say 95,000. So here, when you entered 95,000 over here, 95,000, and when we press enter key, then the entire row is automatically recalculated. Look at this, the last column, net pay is having 97,750. Now when we enter, it becomes 1,09,250. So entire row that is based on this basic salary is recalculated. So we do not require to recalculate this particular thing. So that is characteristics of this software, that is Microsoft Excel. We do not require to recalculate once there is a change in the basic data. Whereas in any database software, whenever you are updating the content in a database, you have to recalculate again and again. Whereas here it is not. Everything is automatically recalculated. Okay, now here, suppose the column width of a particular column is short. Okay, so here, for example, in the case of designation, we'll not see all the characters. Even in this assistant professor content, you can see the entire content over here, but it is not visible over here. The entire ass.professor is not visible over here. So that is because the column width is not sufficient to display this content. So what we can do is, you take your cursor at the border of this particular columns, and you can drag this one. You can drag this border. Okay, you can drag this border. Or there is even another option. You take your cursor at the border and double click your mouse. So it will automatically set the column width depending upon your requirement, depending upon the requirement of that particular column. In the same way, so for example, when we are calculating the gross pay, see, we are getting this type of hash sign. So this displaying the hash sign is not an error. It is not an error, but whenever you are getting the hash sign, it indicates that the column width is not sufficient to display the result or display the numerical values. Okay, so clicking on this one, double clicking on this border, or by dragging the border at the appropriate length, you will get the result. So in this way, you can increase or decrease the column width depending upon the requirement. Same way, sometimes you also require to display, or you want to increase the row width, row height, you can also do it like this one. Okay, you can have the row height like this one. Now in this case, see, all this content in the row number one are displayed at the bottom. Okay, if it is required to display in the center of the row, then you can select this particular row, and here are the three buttons that are used to align your content vertically. Okay, that means this is for displaying the content at the top of the row, this is at the middle, and this is at the bottom. By default, it is at the bottom. But when we click on this one, now look at this. The content is displayed in the center of the room. Then there is one facility available in this Excel, that is a wrap tags. Now you can see in the example, suppose someone has entered say, Microsoft Excel in a one cell. Okay, but because of the size, because say, let's write down Microsoft Excel. Now here, the content is visible. Content is visible because the column width is sufficient to display it. Okay. And right now it is also, but when we are entering something in the next cell, for example, I'm writing MS. Okay, then whole content is not displayed over here. So one thing that we can do is we can increase the column width. We can increase the column width, but sometimes it is not possible to increase the column width. It is not possible to increase the column width. So in that case, we can split the content in number of lines in a row. See, here, by clicking on this wrap text, okay, the entire content is divided into number of lines in a one row. It is in a row number 11 only. Okay, it is displayed in row number 11 only, but the content is splitted into number of lines. So in that way, you can use that particular, you can say, option, that is a wrap text. Then another option is merge and center. Now, sometimes we are having data, something like this one. Let me have all border. Three rows, three columns, or two columns and three rows. Here, I have, say, for example, marks 1 and marks 2. And then afterward, we are having some data in the subsequent rows. Now, this marks are, you can say, for a particular, you can say, semester. Okay. So, if we want to display a title, यहाँ पे suppose हमको कुछ title रखना है, जो कि दोनों columns को you can say include करना है, तो क्या है? We can select both these you can say cells and then afterward merge. So both the cells are now merged and whatever we write, okay, whatever we write, that is displayed in the center of both the columns. Look at this. Okay, यहाँ पे हमने जो wrap ये option select किया है, that is a merge and center. So using which हम दो cells, दो और more cells को combine कर सकते हैं, और जो भी हम data डालते हैं वहाँ पे, that will be in the center of that merge cell. So these are the options available. Okay, now one more thing is, suppose you want to delete unwanted content from the worksheet. So select that portion and press delete key. Okay, one more thing is that after doing this one, suppose you want to save this file. You want to save. So there is an option available here. that is a sale. So by default, here it shows the file name as book1.xlsx. XLSX. So XLSX is the file extension given to this Excel file. Okay. XLSX is the file extension given to this Excel file. So whenever you look at a file containing this extension XLSX, you can very easily recognize that it is a file created using Microsoft Excel. So ये XLSX वो डिफॉल्ट एक्सटेंशन एक्सेल ने दिया हुआ है ओके और बुक वन अभी डिफॉल्ट नेम दिया गया है इन प्लेस ऑफ दैट वी कैन राइट एनी नेम ऑफ अवर चॉइस फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई वांट टू राइट ईएमपी डेटा राइट सो नाउ our data is stored as an emp data.xlsx xlsx okay so xlsx is the file extension for this particular excel file now if you look at this save option then it shows that this file is stored as a one workbook so in this excel whatever the file that we are creating is known as a one workbook so that is the terminology used in this excel the file whatever we are creating is known as a one workbook now as we know that in any of the book textbooks or reference book or any book there are number of pages or we can say number of sheets right so here in this workbook also there are number of sheets at the bottom you can see sheet 1 sheet 2 sheet 3 similarly if you required you can insert more sheets also like this one so depending upon your requirement you can have any number of sheets that is depending upon the memory available okay so here in a particular sheet you can enter a particular type of data suppose this is you can say a salary type of information so you can rename this sheet also take your cursor on this sheet 1 and here when you right click on your mouse when you right click on this one there is a option rename so I am writing emp salary data emp salary okay so I have renamed this particular worksheet similarly I can enter some personal data in this sheet so I can rename this one as emp personal like that okay so in this way you can store or you can organize the data regarding all the employees in different sheets also you can store it in a one sheet also but if you need you can store it in a different sheets also and all the sheets together store as a one workbook or as a one file whatever the file that we are creating as I have mentioned is known as a one workbook you cannot store separate worksheet as a one file but the collection of sheets can be stored as a one file that is known as a one workbook here we have stored only this worksheet but same way we can store a chart sheet also as a one separate sheet we'll see about that one later on even you can write some modules or you can say macro that can also be stored separately as a one sheet and all these things together stored as a one workbook so in this way you can very easily create a worksheet and you can perform any kind of calculation And then, as I have mentioned, that you can very easily prepare a chart in this Excel. So let's see a simple chart right now. Suppose I want to prepare a chart of this particular data. That is the, you can say, data of net pay. So select the content, and then afterward, there is a insert menu in which here are the different options available to select the type of the chart. Okay, these are the different types of the chart. Suppose I want to prepare a column chart, then again in that column chart, there are various options available. Select the appropriate one and press OK button. So in this way, we can very easily prepare a simple chart, right? And there are number of characteristics we can have for a particular chart that we'll see later on. But right now, using on or by clicking only two things, one, selecting the data for which we want to prepare the chart, and then select the appropriate type of the chart, we can prepare a very simple chart. And this is a unique feature available in this Excel. So at this moment, let us end this session.